Hi, my name is Richard, and I'm going to show you how to set up your webcam and microphone on a Mac. So the first thing you want to do is just come over to this video box on the right-hand side of your conference window. Then, just click Send Video in one of these two boxes. The next thing that's going to happen is a window is going to come up asking you to select your camera. Now, on a Mac, usually what you'll want to choose is the one called USB Video Class Video. It's a little redundant, but that's just how Apple chose to name it. So you just click that, and then click OK. Then, a window from the Flash plugin comes up asking if you want to allow or deny access to your webcam and microphone. Now, assuming that you actually do want to use your webcam, you're just going to click the Allow checkbox. Now, the next thing I'm going to show you is how to set up your microphone. Now, this can be controlled from basically just three main settings shown in the participants list. The first is a checkbox called Enable All Microphones. Then there's a checkbox that says Auto and a button that says Talk. Now the first one, Enable All Microphones, is basically going to allow your participants to see the Auto checkbox and the Talk button. Now these two buttons basically allow you to control how your voice is picked up. Now the one on the right, the Talk button, kind of works like a walkie-talkie. If you click it, it can hear you talking, and if you let go, it can't. Now as you can see next to my name, when I'm clicking and holding this, there's a light that lights up right up here. And what that means when it's lit up is that the system can hear me talking. And if our system can hear me, then so can the participants. Now on the left is the auto checkbox. And what this does is it basically just automatically picks up my voice when I'm talking, and then it goes silent when I'm not. So you don't have to worry about clicking and holding the talk button. Now sometimes what's going to happen is you're going to see this light be on all the time when you have the auto checkbox checked, or it won't come on at all. Now to fix that, all you have to do is just right click or control click, or if you have a trackpad you can just put two fingers on the trackpad and then push the button, and then just do that anywhere in the conference window and click Settings. Now this is going to bring up that window asking if you want to allow or deny Flash to use your webcam. Now if you're going to do this a lot, you probably want to click the Remember checkbox right here, just so that you don't have to click Allow every time. And then just go over to this microphone tab on the bottom, and this is where you can control Flash's microphone settings. Now as you can see right here, there's a setting called Record Volume. Now on a MacBook or a MacBook Pro or iMac, you're going to want to set this setting all the way up to the right, because the microphone tends to be pretty sensitive, which means that when you're not talking, it goes all the way down, and then when you are talking, it goes all the way up. And basically, when it breaches this halfway point, that light's going to come on, which means that the system can hear you. So, assuming that you're seeing that bar, just go ahead and click Close. Now, sometimes just setting up your Flash record volume isn't quite going to be enough. What you're going to need to do is go into your Apple menu in the top left corner of your screen, and then click System Preferences. Now this will bring up your Preferences panel, and then you're just going to want to click Sound under the Hardware section. Now make sure you have the Input tab selected, and then make sure you have your internal microphone selected, assuming that's what you're using. And then go down to where it says Input Level and Input Volume. Now on a MacBook Pro or a MacBook or an iMac, this setting is usually going to need to be set around 93 or 95. And with that, your settings are basically complete. So just close the System Preferences window, go back to the conference window, and take a look and see if your voice is automatically being picked up. If it is, that's basically all you need to do. Now I hope you keep these tips in mind so you can have an enjoyable conferencing experience.